private, high-security facility to store your papers and valuables, from jewelry to gold to silver and collectibles. The vault offers ultimate protection in sophisticated surroundings. Select from small security boxes on up to uncommonly large boxes. The vault even offers cased rifle storage and fireproof, high-security computer data storage. A 6,000-pound steel door, a guard, and video surveillance. A personal key system that ensures no one can open your vault box but you. And the vault is the only place offering high-security short-term storage. Open 7 days a week, the vault brings you the advantage of ready access. And there's even a handsome conference room for your private convenience. Check out the vault today at 71st and Lewis in South Point Center or call 496-1048. You'll be impressed. Secure, convenient, private. The vault, meeting the special needs of individuals and business. Call today. They're open, 496-1048.
I got a hand to give credit where it's due. In every single bite of rainbow bread, that great fresh taste comes through. I got a hand to give. You never ever let me down. So I'll keep on patty-cakin' as long as you keep baking the best darn bread around. Keep on baking it fresh. Keep on making it good. So that every single day will start out the way that it should. I got a hand to kiss you. You never ever let me down. And I'll keep on patty caking as long as you keep baking that cheese like butter. Patty cake and rainbow bread.
The following is a pre-recorded creation of a game that should have happened, but never did. The 1982 Justice Bowl Football Classic is on the air. The 1982 Justice Bowl is brought to you by Getty, by Rainbow Bread, by The Vault, and by F&M Bank.
Up as a battle of outstanding football teams. Both had 10-1 seasons and beat Air Force, which plays in the Hall of Fame Bowl. Each team's only loss came to the bowl-bound team. Tulsa to Arkansas, headed for the Blue Bonnet. New Mexico to Brigham Young, headed for the Holiday. Both teams are offensive and feature big play defenses. Maybe the only difference, the size of the institution. Tulsa, mere 6,200 students. New Mexico, more than 22,000. And today they meet under clear skies with mid-50-degree temperatures in a city that has not seen winning football in many years. Hi, I'm Bob Carpenter. Welcome to the first annual of the 1982 Justice Bowl here in Fort Worth. The 10-1 Tulsa University Golden Hurricane against the 10-1 Lobos of the University of New Mexico. With the color commentary, Bob Stevens, and Bob, justice indeed has finally been done.
It certainly has. Two teams that were passed up by the other 16 bowl games have been brought here together. 10-1 records. Only one bowl game in the country has teams with better records. That, of course, the Sugar Bowl coming up on New Year's Day. These teams come in 20-2.
In searching for a site for this game, many people ask the question, why Fort Worth, Texas? Well, Dallas has its own bowl game, the Cotton Bowl, of course. They also have the OU-Texas game every year. And, of course, Houston with the Blue Bonnet Bowl, which Arkansas will be playing in. We wanted to find a neutral site for the ball game. Fort Worth's Amon Carter Stadium, with a seating capacity of 47,000, certainly big enough. And it has been a very hospitable city with many tourist attractions, Bob, for the two teams here this week.
It has been a good week here in Fort Worth for both ball clubs and all of the fans connected with them. Fort Worth has wanted a bowl game. Now they've got it, the Justice Bowl.
Bob, these two teams have very exciting styles of play. They're offensive football teams and make for a great matchup.
Two super football teams rushing TU, third in the nation this year. New Mexico was number 8, but the Lobos can throw the ball a little better, so they come up number 5 in the nation in total offense. Both teams in the top 12 in the nation in scoring, they can put points on the board.
As an added feature to our broadcast crew today, the sports director at KOB AM 77 in Albuquerque and the voice of the Lobos, Mike Roberts, with a pregame report from the sideline.
Hi, Bob. Good to be with you both. And the first annual Justice Bowl, I know the New Mexico fans are excited about today's game between two teams with great records. New Mexico boosters are poured into Fort Worth to back their Lobos. Quarterback Dave Osborne is the man who makes New Mexico's offense go. And he's been the man of the hour so often this year. Eight times New Mexico has trailed in the second half of the ball game, and Osborne has brought them back to win. The weather is perfect. Both these teams have faced three common opponents, Air Force, New Mexico State, and North Texas State, and they've beaten all three.
Thank you, Mike. We look forward to your comments today. This game heard on a three-station network, KRAV FM 96, KGTO AM 1050 in Tulsa, KOB AM 77 in Albuquerque. The Justice Bowl is minutes away from kickoff. And after this timeout, we'll look at the records of the teams and how they got here. This is the Justice Bowl Radio Network.
At F&M Bank, our number one ranking in return on average assets, return on stockholders' equity, and capital to assets ratio of the five largest Tulsa banks with assets of at least $100 million is backed by one more strength. Quick response, often within 24 hours. The F&M Bank and Trust Company.
Where business is concerned, we're concerned at F&M.
Member FDIC.
The American Theater Company, Getty, and KJRH TV are proud to present a musical adaptation of Charles Dickens' famous holiday story, A Christmas Carol. Tickets are now on sale for this family musical, which runs from December 3rd through December 24th at the Tulsa Performing Arts Center. And as a special Christmas gift to you, Getty and KJRH TV are offering special discount coupons with $1 off any adult ticket. Just stop by your nearest Getty station throughout the Tulsa area and ask for your free Dickens Christmas Carol discount coupon. There's no purchase necessary. The American Theater Company's presentation of Dickens Christmas Carol, a great way for your family to get into the spirit of the holiday season. Announcing two new reasons to come charging into Getty, Visa and MasterCard. America's most popular credit cards are now accepted at participating Getty stations. It's easier than ever for you to get a tank full of Getty gasoline. Next time you need a fill-up, take your cap off to Getty.
Both TU and New Mexico, 10-1. This, of course, as we said before, the second-best matchup of any bowl game except for the Sugar Bowl that has the top two teams in the nation, Georgia and Penn State, with a cumulative record of 21-1. Justice Bowl teams are 20-2. And TU's head coach John Cooper obviously believes his team belongs in a postseason bowl.
You mentioned we've got the best record of any teams other than Penn State and Georgia, which is playing for the national championship. So, you know, we're ranked in the top 20 and very deserving of being in a bowl game. Did everything we need to do on the football field, but unfortunately, those bowl people aren't looking at the one-loss record.
What's your assessment of New Mexico's program from what you know about it?
Well, they did it. They had a great program last year. Coach Morrison did a great job. Of course, he's the head coach of South Carolina right now. They did a great job, had a good football team. I wasn't aware that they scored 34 points a game, so they must have had a great offensive football team.
They certainly do, Bob. The Lobos can not only throw the ball, but they can run it as well.
As Mike Roberts indicated in the pregame show, they can move the ball and move it extremely well, both by the air and on the ground. David Osborne, the number a highly ranked passer on the season, number 28 in total offense nationally, number 16 in passing in the country, and they can run. Mike Carter running for over 700 yards in the season. Michael Johnson, the fullback, 650 yards. Osborne himself can keep the ball and ran for almost 550 yards on the season.
They're not physical, but the Lobos do have an opportunistic defense led by coordinator and new head coach Julie Dunn. A young 35-year-old New Mexico sports information director, John Keith, says, has been one of the nation's best assistants.
He's been an assistant coach for 13 years, and he's probably the most innovative defensive coach that I've ever been associated with, because he had a team at New Mexico that was small in stature, a lot of speed, but no size. And so we couldn't stand in and play a standard defense, you know, like most football teams do. We had to stunt and gamble and rush a lot of men and try to fool the other team as to what we were going to do. Nobody could ever get a reading on what we were going to do and how we played, how we were going to play them, because we did so many different things.
They certainly did, and they came up with some tremendously big plays during the season. Neither team appears to have a glaring weakness. In fact, they're so even, the outcome may not be decided till the closing minute. 47,000 fans are on their feet, and here comes the Hurricane.
3-point win over Air Force, then got blitzed 38-0 at Arkansas. But after that, 9 consecutive wins, TU with the second longest winning streak in the nation. Victories over Oklahoma State, Kansas, New Mexico State, Southern Illinois, Drake, Wichita State, West Texas State, Indiana State, and North Texas State. In those last 5 games, the lowest point total TU had was 30.
New Mexico had an outstanding season as well. 10-1, second place in the Western Athletic Conference, second only to Brigham Young. In 81, they were only 4-7-1, so a tremendous turnaround. They won at Wyoming, beat Texas Tech, and Nevada Las Vegas at home, beat Air Force, lost at home to BYU 40-12, and won their last 6 ball games at San Diego State, at home to New Mexico State, at North Texas State, and UTEP, and then at home to Colorado State and Hawaii. It looks like the Lobos are ready to come onto the field. Here they come. Shapes up as an exciting afternoon of football. 2-10-1 ball clubs who did not go to bowl games, but as we said earlier, finally, justice will be done.
It certainly will be. The key matchup I have to watch today, TU's vaunted ground attack. Michael Gunter, 133 yards a game. Ken Lacy, 100 yards a game against New Mexico's stonewall rushing defense. They were 13th in the nation, only giving up just over 100 yards a game on the ground. So that might be the critical thing. If TU can move the ball on the ground, they could run it up and score a lot of points. If they have some trouble, they'll be forced to throw, and the Hurricane has not thrown the ball that well all year.
So here in Fort Worth, before 47,000 screaming fans, the stage is set. The first ever Justice Bowl kicks off after this message from our network station.
The Vault, a private, high-security facility to store your papers and valuables, from jewelry to gold to silver and collectibles. The Vault offers ultimate protection in sophisticated surroundings. Select from small security boxes on up to uncommonly large boxes. The Vault even offers cased rifle storage and fireproof, high-security computer data storage. A 6,000-pound steel door, a guard, and video surveillance. A personal key system that ensures no one can open your vault box but you. And the vault is the only place offering high-security short-term storage. Open 7 days a week, the vault brings you the advantage of ready access and is even a handsome conference room for your private convenience. Check out the vault today at 71st and Lewis in South Point Center or call 496-1048. You'll be impressed. Secure, convenient, private. The Vault. Meeting the special needs of individuals and business. Call today. They're open, 496-1048.
Welcome back to Amon Carter Stadium in Fort Worth. 47,000 fans ready for the opening kickoff. Bob, both of these teams, of course, felt they should have gone to bowl games this year. They did not. Here they are in the Justice Bowl. Both of them have what you might call fair bowl history.
Well, fair, I guess. New Mexico 2-3-1 in 6 bowls, but New Mexico has not been to a bowl game in 21 years. The last bowl game New Mexico played in, the 1961 Aviation Bowl, when they beat Western Michigan by a count of 28-12. That bowl, needless to say, no longer exists. Of course, the last time TU has been to a bowl, 1976, when they lost in the Independence Bowl, 20-16 to McNeese State, the Hurricane with a 3-6 overall bowl record.
The officials for today's game, the referee retiring after 25 years as a football referee from the Big 8 Conference. Of course, we had to get a neutral referee, Vance Carlson. The umpire is Harold Standridge. The head linesman is Bob Cox. The line judge, Bill Dugan. The back judge, Eldon Hall. The alternate, Daniel Huber. Bob, I know this is a great honor for them to be able to work a game like this.
That's a ball game they also didn't expect to be working, of course, until just the last few weeks. And it's great to get Vance Carlson. He thought his last ball game was going to be the OU-Nebraska game of a few weeks back. But he wanted to leave on a bowl game note, and this is his opportunity as well.
Okay, we're ready for the opening kickoff. Ready for TU is number 6-2 Crum, the senior from St. Louis. Crum, of course, the all-time Missouri Valley Conference leader in field goals, has broken every TU record that existed. So he lines it up and points, and we're just about ready for the first ever Justice Bowl.
Crum approaching the football. There's the kick. It's going to go long and out of the end zone. Crum puts it out of the end zone to start the football game. The TU fans like that. So it'll be first and 10 for the Lobos at their own 20-yard line.
About a 10-mile-an-hour breeze blowing out of the south, and Steve Crum using that breeze to his advantage, kicking it all the way out, making UNM start from their own 20.
Let's set the offensive line for you now. For the Lobos of New Mexico, the left tackle, number 50, Ken at 8. The left guard, number 70, Mike A. Carter. The center, number 51, Paul Zamprelli. The right guard, number 64, Don Elliott. The right tackle, number 67, Johnny Young, in front of David Osborne, the quarterback, will set the other position for you after the first play. And the first play is first and 10 at the New Mexico 20-yard line. Osborne, the quarterback. He's got the snap, gives it off to number 41, Mike Carter. Off tackle, he's up to about the 24, maybe to the 25-yard line. In on the stop there for TU, Brian Burroughs, the linebacker who plays normally with Blake Bortman. Cliff Abbott and Bob Babbitt usually pair off for TU. And Burroughs, the senior from St. Louis, the man who came up to make the hit.
Second down and 5, it brings up for New Mexico. This is an interesting situation for them. They love to option the football. Osborne can run it. Osborne can throw it. A number of different things could happen right here.
They're in the veer split back option. It is a option offense. You can tell by the number of times Osborne's run the football this year. He has run it 141 times. Second and 5 for the Lobos. Here comes Carter. Rather, Osborne, he's got the snap. Gives it off for Michael Johnson, the junior from San Diego, around the left side. And he's got about 4 out to maybe the 29-yard line. Making the tackle, the left quarterback, Brent Dennis, coming up on the hit. Helping out also, again, Blake Borkman, the senior from Dallas, showing good pursuit coming to the outside. The Lobos, Bob, will have a 3rd and 1.
Hurricane having to rely on its linebackers and defensive backs to make a lot of tackles. As a matter of fact, Babbitt and Burroughs were 1, 2, 3 in tackles on the ball club this year.
Lobos break the huddle quickly. We played 1 minute so far. Osborne's run the ball 141 yards this year. He's going to keep it on 3rd and 1. He goes to his right on the option, and he's got a couple of yards, maybe 3, and that'll be good for the first down for the Lobos, the first down of the game. 1st and 10, New Mexico at their own 32.
Osborne that time showing TU what he would like to show them on a 3rd and 1. He faked the pass and kept the ball around the right side for the first down.
One of the interesting things about this New Mexico team, they go a lot with the element of surprise. They'll do some funny things on first down, even second down. So we'll see what David Osborne has up his sleeve now. It's 1st and 10 at the 32. He's back to throw, looking over the middle. He's got a man, John Lane, the senior from Pueblo. He's going to get 12 yards all the way out to the 44. The strong safety, Timmy Gibbs, the sophomore from Bixby, Oklahoma, coming up on the stop of New Mexico, has 2 straight first downs.
6'1", 180, Timmy Gibbs, overmatched against John Lane, the big tight end for the Lobos. He's 6'1", 225, a big guy from Pueblo.
Lane, 20 catches for 306 yards, his longest 62 this year. 1st and 10 at the 44 for the New Mexico Lobos. Osborne going to his left. He fakes the handoff, goes across the line, and he'll get maybe 1, as coming up on a good defensive play at the line was the sophomore from Tulsa Memorial High School, Kevin Lilly, number 77. Maybe 1 yard in the play. It'll set up a 2nd and 9 for the Lobos at their own 45.
Let's set TU's defensive front quickly. Joe Blankenship on the left defensive end, a senior. Kevin Lilly, the sophomore you mentioned a moment ago, 6'3", 238 from Tulsa Memorial. 6'2", sophomore, the nose guard, Brian Bruner. A 6'4", 235-pound junior, Tom Baldwin from Lansing, Illinois, and on the right side, defensive end Carl Pendleton, a senior from Hopkinsville, Kentucky. Young defensive line.
Osborne with the give. He gives it off for Mike Carter. The senior is out across midfield into TU territory for the first time. It'll be a gain of 6 for the senior from Albuquerque Sandia High School, and he's got the Lobos up into 3rd down position. It'll be 3rd and 3 at the TU 49-yard line. So I wouldn't not be surprised to see New Mexico go for it here, Bob, on 3rd and 3. And, of course, they've got really 2 downs to make it now that they're in Hurricane territory.
They really do. If they don't make it now, don't be at all surprised if Joe Lee Dunn and Joe Morrison decide to do something fancy on 4th.
They, of course, 1 of 1 in 3rd down situations so far. Osborne looking back to throw. Now it's a draw play. Carter on the carry. He's going to get across the line of scrimmage. Maybe 1 yard or 2. Brian Bruner, the Tulsa nose guard, the sophomore from Washington High School in Tulsa, he smelt out the play pretty well, and that will leave the Lobos about a foot short. They'll be faced with a fourth and one at the TU 48-yard line.
Very interesting. Joe Morrison pulling his offensive ball club off. They're going to go ahead and kick on fourth and one.
Bobby Ferguson is on to kick the football. The senior from Coldwater, Mississippi, has punted 67 times this year, averaging 42.3, his longest 65. He's got it up in the air. Off to a good snap. Ball is spiraling out to about the TU's 12-yard line. Brent Dennis has it there. He cuts outside. He's got some room along the sideline. He's loose across the 20 to the 25 and out to about the 27-yard line. Brent Dennis averaging 11.7 for return. That time he got 15. So the Hurricane will have first and 10 at the 27. We are scoreless in the first half of play. Tulsa nothing, New Mexico nothing. We'll be back with TU's first possession right after this timeout.
You guys ready?
Yeah. Come on, children, sing with me. I know you know this song. And I know, like me, you love rainbow bread. So sing along. We'll put our hands and voices together. Together we can't go wrong. Sing along. Sing along. Patty cake. Rainbow bread. As best as bread can be. Patty cake. Rainbow bread. For me.
Bob Stevens along with Bob Carpenter and Mike Roberts setting the Golden Hurricane on their first offensive possession. David Pearson, the left tackle, a 6'1 junior. John Kaspersky, Flores at Missouri, is the left guard. He wears number 67. David Imes, Pasadena, California, 6'2", 231-pound senior, is at center. On the right side, the two big seniors, Steve Cox from Liberal, Kansas, 241 pounds, the right tackle, 272-pound All-American Sid Abramowitz from Fort Leavenworth, Kansas.
It's been a very impressive TU offensive line throughout the season. They, of course, a big reason for the success of the Palomino Express, Michael Gunter and Ken Lacy. First and 10 for the Hurricanes. They're at their own 27-yard line. Skip asked the quarterback. The senior from Phoenix comes out. His first give will be around the right side to Michael Gunter. He's across the line of scrimmage. He's got five. He's got six. Gunter is going to go up near the 35, maybe the 36-yard line. As he peeks around the right side, Michael Gunter gets nine on first down. Chuck Best, the right defensive tackle, pursuing. And the right cornerback coming up to make the tackle, Julius Johnson from Plano, Texas.
Michael Gunter setting a TU single-season rushing record, 1,464 yards. The number seven rusher in the country, and he carried a couple of backs right there before he was finally brought down.
An impressive duo of running backs the University of Tulsa has. Second and one for TU at its own 36-yard line. The give is to the first man through. Ken Lacy, the senior, has maybe a couple out to about the 39-yard line. We'll call it three, which will be a first down for Tulsa for the Hurricanes, getting it first and 10 at their own 39-yard line.
New Mexico also getting two first downs on their drive. Again, Skip asked the quarterback, Michael Gunter and Ken Lacy, the running back. Out wide, Kirk Phillips. The split end, the flanker will be David Hersey.
Skip asked passing-wise, 45 of 102 this year with four interceptions, 596 yards, 44%. He's back to throw on first and 10. Looking outside for the tight end, Kurt Steinhauer. It's underthrown a little bit. It'll fall incomplete for TU, missing on its first passing opportunity of the ball game. It'll be second and 10, still at the 39.
As you said, the skipper only 44% on the season. The senior from Phoenix was more the field general type. For those of you listening in New Mexico, Skip was not a kind of a David Osborne with that high completion percentage and a lot of yards. He just ran the show and handed the ball to the two in the Palomino Express.
Helping out on the defensive play there, the super linebacker, the 5'10 sophomore from Linwood, California. He's going to be a great one. He already is. Johnny Jackson, number 47 of New Mexico. Second and 10 at the 39. Ass optioning, looking to his right. He fakes the handoff. He's going to keep it. and he'll get a couple across the 40-yard line, maybe out to the 41, which will leave TU with third and long, Bob.
Difficult situation for the Golden Hurricane. They come into this game knowing that New Mexico is tough against the run, but a bit susceptible to the pass. We'll see now if TU succumbs to that temptation to throw the football on third down.
The right defensive end, Jimmy Carter, a junior from Austin, Texas, with 107 tackles this year. Second on the team only to Johnny Jackson's 127, in on the stop that time. TU on third and eight, bringing it out now at their own 41-yard line. Skip Ass is back to throw. He's looking for Kirk Phillips. It's incomplete along the sidelines as Phillips went down. Two first down yardage, about 9 yards down the field and cut outside. And TU now will be faced with fourth and eight at its own 41-yard line and a kicking situation.
You talk about Bobby Ferguson, 42.3 on the season. Steve Cook, almost as good, 41.1 on the year. Did not have any kicks blocked and had a long kick of 73 on the season.
Steve Cook, the senior from Bristow, Oklahoma, back to kick it away. Johnny Parrish, the senior cornerback of New Mexico, back to get it. Oh, it's a good-looking spiral all the way down to the New Mexico 11. Parrish trying to work out of trouble. He gets it back to about the 15-yard line. In to make the stop there for TU, Blake Workman on the special team, as well as some of the secondary people, Jimmy Gibbs there, along with Tony Buford, the freshman from St. Louis. It'll be first and 10 for the Lobos at their own 15-yard line.
Excellent defensive series. The only thing that kept TU out of trouble was the great kick by Steve Cook.
We'll set the skill people now for New Mexico for you. The split end is number three, Derwin Williams, a junior from Brownwood, Texas. The tight end, number 84, John Lane from Pueblo, Colorado. The flanker, number four, Keith McGee from San Diego. The halfback, number 44, Michael Johnson from San Diego. And the great one, Mike Carter, rushing for 722 yards this year. It'll be first and 10 for the Lobos at their own 15-yard line. Quarterback is David Osborne. He gives it off now to the first man through on the draw play. Mike Johnson, not too much there, Bob, as the middle of the TU defensive line, Brian Bruner and Kevin Lilly, collapsed on it.
TU did a good job on that play the last time New Mexico had the ball. The draw play is New Mexico one of their better gimmicks because they're such an option-type team. Anytime you can freeze those linebackers and run the guy up the middle, you figure to have some success, but the Hurricane was looking for it.
So far, Carter, three rushes for 13 yards to lead everybody. Johnson, two for five. Osborne, the quarterback, two for four. On second and nine at the 16, David Osborne looking to his right. He's going to keep it. Oh, and a good defensive play made by the right defensive end of Tulsa. Carl Pendleton, the senior from Hopkinsville, Kentucky, knocked him down. At the line of scrimmage for no gain, it'll be third and nine.
Carl Pendleton did everything but sweep off the field after the games this year. 43 tackles, a couple of fumble recoveries, even had a blocked field goal.
Crowd has not seen any scoring as of yet. New Mexico one out of two in third down situations so far. It's third and nine, deep in their own territory at the 16. Osborne is back to throw. Good protection. He's looking on the right side for the flanker, Keith McGee. It's overthrown to the sideline. May have been tipped out there by the right cornerback, Robert Estes, as he knocked it away. So it'll be fourth and nine for the Lobos as, again, the TU defense holds, Bob. And so far, the great offenses have not been able to move the football.
They really haven't. A couple of fired-up defensive ball clubs. Of course, Mike Knoll, the defensive coordinator of the Golden Hurricane, may be the one guy who can match Joe Lee Dunn for intensity down on that sideline.
Fourth and nine for the Lobos. Bobby Ferguson back to punt. He had a 36-yarder his first time. The ball is in the air. It's a pretty good-looking spiral. TU will have good field position. Brent Dennis at the 44. Not much chance to run it back, though, as the defense collapses on him there. In on the stop, the free safety, Rain Hornbeck on the special team, as well as one of the left cornerbacks, Sammy Perry. So on that 40-yard kick, TU will take over first and 10 at its own 47-yard line. We're still scoreless with 6:42 left in the first quarter of play. We'll be back with more of the 82 Justice Ball after this timeout.
Check the five largest banks in Tulsa with assets of at least $100 million. Compare their return on average assets, return on stockholders' equity, and capital-to-assets ratio. You'll find that F&M Bank ranks number one in all three categories. We're the right size at the right time. The F&M Bank and Trust Company.
Where business is concerned, we're concerned at F&M.
F&M, we're the right size at the right time.
Member FDIC.
The American Theater Company, Getty, and KJRH TV are proud to present a musical adaptation of Charles Dickens' famous holiday story, A Christmas Carol. Tickets are now on sale for this family musical, which runs from December 3rd through December 24th at the Tulsa Performing Arts Center. And as a special Christmas gift to you, Getty and KJRH TV are offering special discount coupons with $1 off any adult ticket. Just stop by your nearest Getty station throughout the Tulsa area and ask for your free Dickens Christmas Carol discount coupon. There's no purchase necessary. The American Theater Company's presentation of Dickens Christmas Carol, a great way for your family to get into the spirit of the holiday season. Announcing two new reasons to come charging into Getty, Visa and MasterCard. America's most popular credit cards are now accepted at participating Getty stations. It's easier than ever for you to get a tankful of Getty gasoline. Next time you need a fill-up, take your cap off to Getty.
6:08 left, first quarter action. Bob, quickly, the offensive set so far.
New Mexico in their two possessions, 34 total offensive yards. The Golden Hurricane in one possession, just the one first down and 14 yards.
GU with the football for the second time. Skip Bass looking to his right. He wants to keep. He's going to be knocked down behind the line of scrimmage on a big defensive play by number 47, the 5'10", 205-pound sophomore, Johnny Jackson from Linwood, California. Western Athletic Conference Defensive Player of the Year, a third-team APL America, the leader in tackles his freshman and sophomore year. It'll set up a second and 12 for TU after the two-yard loss. The Hurricane moving from its own 45-yard line, trying to get into Lobo territory for the first time. Hand off to the senior, Kenny Lacy. He's got some running room. He's across midfield to about the 48-yard line of New Mexico. It'll still be third down and semi-long yardage for TU, but the Hurricane in Lobo territory for the first time.
New Mexico fans, Ken Lacy is the man that usually runs.
It'll set up a second and 12 for TU after the two-yard loss. The Hurricane moving from its own 45-yard line, trying to get into Lobo territory for the first time. Hand off to the senior, Kenny Lacy. He's got some running room. He's across midfield to about the 48-yard line of New Mexico. It'll still be third down and semi-long yardage for TU, but the Hurricane in Lobo territory for the first time.
New Mexico fans, Ken Lacy is the man that usually runs up the middle for the Hurricane. Michael Gunter runs the same toss sweep that John Cooper loves to run so much, as he is usually the wide runner.
Tulsa is one football team that you will not expect to pass on third down. They rush for 315 yards a game and only pass for 75, so about 80% of their yardage and total yardage coming on the ground. Third and five at the 48. Gunner has the handoff, sweeps to the right side. He's going to get the first down, out of bounds to the near sideline, and TU will have another first down, this time down to the UNM 41-yard line.
Michael Gunner diving for that last 3 yards before going out of bounds for the first down, the Hurricane's second first down on the ball game.
Tulsa now with some offensive momentum for the first time in the game. They had a first down their first possession, then had to kick it away. First and 10 at the Lobos, 41-yard line. Get past the quarterback, hands it off to the man to his right. Kenny Lacy off tackle behind Steve Cox. He's going to get about five down to across the 40 to about the 36-yard line. Brought down the play by Chuck Best, the right defensive tackle out of Plano, Texas, and the left cornerback, rather the left linebacker, Johnny Jackson, who came up to help out as well.
The one time TU will do things differently is when they've got a situation like this, second and five. They like to go to the tight end or maybe even put it up long.
Second and five for the Hurricane at the 36. Clock shows 4:45 left, scoreless first quarter. Hand off again is to Kenny Lacy, number five, straight up the middle behind the center, David Hines. And he'll get maybe a couple. It'll be a three-yard gain, and Tulsa now will be faced with a third and two at the Lobo 34-yard line.
Interesting call coming up for Skip Ash. He may go with a long count. He may try to make something happen here to draw New Mexico into a defense they don't want to play.
We have a penalty flag on the play. It looks like it's going to go against the Lobos. Let's get on to the referee, Vance Carlson, to find out what the penalty is all about.
Offside!
So it moves TU for a first down at the 29-yard line of New Mexico in Tulsa. With the help of that penalty and some good running by the Palomino Express, Lacy and Gunter has the first down.
An important penalty now. Let's see if the Hurricane decide to open things up or continue to stay with that successful ground game.
Skip is back to pass. He's looking down the left side for his flanker. He's got number 82, David Hersey. He gets out of bounds at the 20-yard line. And TU will get good yardage. It won't be enough for the first down on second and one on a 9-yard gain. But again, TU not just able to get the first down, but good yardage on first and 10.
Now the Hurricane can do a number of different things. They can give the ball to Gunter or Lacy. They can throw deep. They can ask and keep the ball and kind of play it by ear. Lots of things can happen on second and one.
Ask is one of three for 9 yards thus far. Moving on second and one. Gives it off to the second man through. Michael Gunter has the first down. Penalty flags on the play. And it looks like it's in the vicinity of the Tulsa backfield, which could indicate some kind of illegal motion, maybe even a holding call. Let's go down again to the referee, Vance Carlson, for the call.
Holding, offense, second down.
That will be a costly penalty, Bob. TU had the first down at the 20. Now they're going to be back second and 11, all the way back at the 30.
Tough call now coming up for the Hurricane as this changes everything.
Skip Ass not throwing the football much on this drive, but a couple of times he's looking again for Michael Gunter. Gunter on the sweep to the left side behind Kaspersky and Pearson. He's got some good yardage down across the 25 to about the 22-yard line of New Mexico, making the tackle there for the Lobos, the left cornerback Sammy Pierce, as well as the strong safety Huey Chancellor out of Odessa, Texas.
Michael Gunter, 3 carries for 24 yards. He led the nation in yards per carry. It's 7.5 on the season.
Tulsa now, interesting choice to make here on 3rd and 3 at the Lobo 22-yard line. They're certainly within 2 from field goal range. They'd like to bring it down and get 6 and get on the scoreboard. 3rd and 3 at the 22. Skip Ass looking back to throw. He's looking to his left for the split end. Kirk Phillips has it down the sideline. Oh, he's inside the 5. Knocked down at the 4-yard line. It'll be 1st and goal at the 4 for Tulsa.
Kirk Phillips breaking free and getting by the Parrish, the left cornerback, and getting 1st down room for the Golden Hurricane. Skip Ass doesn't throw the ball long very often. 18 about as far as the Hurricane will toss it.
Tulsa now, 1st down. They have attempted 3 and they've made 2 so far. They have 1st and goal at the 4-yard line. Eastham, Greenwood, Wilson, Best, and Carter digging in now for the Lobos. The give is the first man through. Michael Gunter off left tackle. Kaspersky the block, but he doesn't get a whole lot there. Al Greenwood and Kelly Wilson, the left defensive tackle and the nose guard, in on the tackle.
The one thing that might do for the Golden Hurricane, it puts the ball right in the middle of the field. They started from the right hash mark and ran under left.
It'll be 2nd and goal for Tulsa at the 3 as the Hurricane band strikes it up. 2nd and goal at the 3. Skip Ash optioning to his right. He's going to keep. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage and maybe gain a yard. Coming up, Johnny Jackson, the great right side linebacker, as well as Chuck Best, the right defensive tackle on the stop. And they had a whole lot of support there as the Lobos are really stacked up defensively. It'll be 3rd and goal from the 2.
Great defensive effort by Joe Lee Dunn's crew as they did stack it right up. They knew what the Hurricane was going to do, probably run the football. TU does not throw when they get down close.
Michael Gunter and Ken Lacy, 23 touchdowns between them on the ground this year. Lacy with 12, Gunter with 11. You have to think one of them will get the call. A minute 16 left on the clock. It's to Lacy up the middle. The Golden Hurricane is on the scoreboard with 59 seconds left in the first quarter. 6-0 on the 2-yard run by Ken Lacy, his 13th touchdown of the year.
Ken Lacy, 5 carries on the afternoon for 20 yards. That one getting the first 6 on the board in the Justice Bowl. 11 plays, 53 yards. TU had the ball for better than 5 minutes.
Duke Romley, senior from St. Louis now, is on for the extra point. 37 of 37 this year, 117 of 118 in his career. The snap is down, the holder is Scott Brown, and it is good. So the Hurricane is on the scoreboard. In the last minute of the first quarter, it's Tulsa leading New Mexico by a 7-0 score. We'll be back with a wrap-up of first quarter action in the 82 Justice Bowl in just a moment.
The American Theater Company, Getty, and KJRH-TV are proud to present a musical adaptation of Charles Dickens' famous holiday story, A Christmas Carol. Tickets are now on sale for this family musical, which runs from December 3rd through December 24th at the Tulsa Performing Arts Center. And as a special Christmas gift to you, Getty and KJRH-TV are offering special discount coupons with $1 off any adult ticket. Just stop by your nearest Getty station throughout the Tulsa area and ask for your free Dickens Christmas Carol discount coupon. There's no purchase necessary. The American Theater Company's presentation of Dickens Christmas Carol, a great way for your family to get into the spirit of the holiday season. Announcing two new reasons to come charging into Getty, Visa and MasterCard. America's most popular credit cards are now accepted at participating Getty stations. It's easier than ever for you to get a tank full of Getty gasoline. Next time you need a fill-up, take your cap off to Getty.
As Bob told you a moment ago, 11 plays, 53 yards, 5:09, the time of possession for Tulsa. They overcame a holding penalty. They benefited from one penalty on New Mexico. And the Hurricane leads it 7-0 here. With just 59 seconds left first quarter, Sue Crum with the kickoff. He's approaching the football. Danny Allen is back to get it. The ball is in the air. Allen averaging 18 yards a return this year. Has it. Adds all the way down the 3-yard line. He's out to the 15, the 20, and knocked down at the 21-yard line. A good run back by Danny Allen as he hit right on his average of 18 yards.
Danny Buford, a freshman out of St. Louis, making the tackle for the Golden Hurricane. The key play in that big drive for TU, though, the pass from Skip Ask to Kirk Phillips, 18 yards. It got him down to the 4-yard line on a 3rd-and-3.
It'll be 1st-and-10 for the Lobos at their own 21-yard line. 39 seconds left. First quarter, Tulsa up 7-0. David Osborne looking to his left. It's a sweep. The pitch goes to Johnson. Johnson across the 25. To about the 26-yard line, and a 6-yard gain for New Mexico will leave them with a 2nd-and-4 at the 27-yard line.
Cliff Abbott and Tom Baldwin making the play. We mentioned earlier TU's linebackers making a lot of tackles all season long, 89 of them for club-leading Abbott.
It'll be 2nd-and-4 at the 27 for New Mexico. Osborne looking to throw. He's back looking for McGee on the right side. He's got his man along the sideline. It'll be a 1st down for the Lobos all the way out to the TU 38-yard line. Boy, that ball was really delivered right on the money by David Osborne, who was 105 out of 216 this year with 8 touchdowns. Or rather, 15 touchdowns and 1,609 yards. He put it right on the money, Bob, to his favorite receiver, Keith McGee, the senior from San Diego.
Keith McGee, 39 catches, a 16.5-yard average, and 5 scores this year, 44 catches for over 700 yards a year ago.
Last play of the first quarter coming up, 1st-and-10 at the 38, only 2 seconds showing on the clock. Osborne looking again. McGee across the middle. He's got him. He's across the 45. He'll be stopped in midfield by TU's free safety, Kelly Beasley. Trent Dennis also in on the stop, and that will end the first quarter of play with New Mexico having 1st-and-10 at the midfield stripe. University of Tulsa leading it after the end of the first quarter, 7-0. Let's go down to the sideline now for a report from KOB Radio's Mike Roberts.
Well, you know, Bob, it's something new for New Mexico to be behind at the end of the first quarter. Only twice this year have the Lobos been ahead. I've been impressed with Tulsa's ground game, and, well, I should be. Two backs with more than 1,000 yards each. New Mexico's defense will have to make some adjustments in the second quarter. I know that Morrison was hoping to keep the ball a little more and keep it away from Tulsa's offense.
But the Lobos offensively are on the move, and that'll do it for the first quarter of play. Tulsa up by a score of 7-0. We'll be back with the second quarter of play as the 82 Justice Bowl continues from Fort Worth.
The 1982 Justice Bowl football classic is a pre-recorded creation of a game that should have happened, but never did. private, high-security facility to store your papers and valuables, from jewelry to gold to silver and collectibles. The vault offers ultimate protection in sophisticated surroundings. Select from small security boxes on up to uncommonly large boxes. The vault even offers cased rifle storage and fireproof, high-security computer data storage. A 6,000-pound steel door, a guard, and video surveillance. A personal key system that ensures no one can open your vault box but you. And the vault is the only place offering high-security, short-term storage. Open 7 days a week, the vault brings you the advantage of ready access. And there's even a handsome conference room for your private convenience. Check out the vault today at 71st and Lewis in South Point Center or call 496-1048. You'll be impressed. Secure, convenient, private. The vault, meeting the special needs of individuals and business. Call today. They're open, 496-1048.
The Lobos and the Golden Hurricane, each with four first downs in the first quarter. Total offense, 65 yards for New Mexico, 73 for the University of Tulsa. Michael Gunter, the leading rusher in the game, with 25 yards on four carries. But, of course, David Osborne of New Mexico, the top passer, 3 out of 4 for 37, Bob.
I would have to think those total yardage figures a little bit lower than the season average of the team. Not a real offensive first quarter of play. The Lobos, first and 10 at the midfield stripe. David Osborne, the quarterback, looking back to throw. Now it's a draw play off for Michael Carter. He's down maybe the 48 or the 47-yard line. Brought down there as the linebacker smelled it out well. It was Cliff Abbott, the 6'0 junior from Liberal, Kansas. Bob Babbage, the 6-foot-tall senior from Aliquippa, Pennsylvania, on the stop for Tulsa.
That's the third time now they've run that draw play, and that's the most yardage they gained out of it, just three.
It'll be second and 7 for the Lobos at the Tulsa 47-yard line. Carter has been a workhorse here lately. He's going to get the football again, sweeping around the right side. He's across the 45, down to the 41. Oh, a hard hit there. He was really racked up by Brent Dennis, the cornerback, who came up and whacked him. And Mike Carter is down, Bob, and he is hurting a little bit.
They're going to have to help Michael Carter off the field. He is going off under his own power, but it appears to be his right leg. Mike Carter leading the ball game for the Lobos.
Coming in to replace him is number 33, Denny Carter, a 5'8", 160-pound junior from Gainesville, Florida, who rushed for 426 yards this year on 70 carries with four touchdowns. It will be third and 1 for the Lobos at the Tulsa 41-yard line. Clock showing 14:09 left. They give the ball to Allen. He sweeps to the left, cuts back upfield now. He's going to get 5 or 6 down across the 40 to the TU 35-yard line. First and 10 for New Mexico.
Nice hustle by Denny Allen. Carried the ball 70 times on the season. Averaged 6 yards a carry and scored 4 times. Michael Carter leading with 5 carries for 22 yards. 6th first down for the Lobos.
So the Lobos with some momentum here. This drive started back at their own 21-yard line. After the kickoff of Sue Crum when TU had scored. It is 1st and 10 at the 35. The give is to Michael Johnson straight up the middle. Not much there. Brian Bruner, Kevin Lilly, and Tom Baldwin, the middle of the TU defensive line, collapsed on him. And we've got flags on the field. It looks like, again, it's in the New Mexico backfield, which could indicate some kind of motion penalty or maybe holding. Let's get out to the referee for the call, Vance Carlson.
Holding!
It'll be 1st down for the Lobos. It'll move the ball back 10 yards. 1st and 10 at the Tulsa 45-yard line. Penalty so far against New Mexico, 2 for 15 yards. And that was a costly one. It's 1st and 20 at the 45. David Osborne is back. He's looking to throw now. It's off the left side for split end. Derwin Williams, he's down across the 35, the 30, down to the Tulsa 28-yard line. Derwin Williams, the 6'3 junior out of Brownwood, Texas, on the reception, and a well-thrown ball by David Osborne.
And a great catch by Derwin Williams. He got in behind the Hurricane secondary to make the catch, and then a fine run after that, bringing up a 2nd down and short from a 1st and 20.
Osborne now, 4 out of 5, 80% for 54 yards. He's throwing the football well. Tulsa's been running it. 2nd and 3 at the 28. That was a big 17-yard gain on 1st down. The give is to Denny Allen. He sweeps to the left. left. He's got an opening. Cuts up field. Blankenship can't stop him. He's going to get down across the 25 to about the TU 21-yard line. It'll be first and 10 for the Lobos. They had a first and 20, Bob, and got it all back in two plays.
Denny Allen, a little jitterbug, 5'8", 160. He can dance with the best of them, first and 10 Lobos.
Of course, they're still concerned about the condition of Mike Carter on the sidelines. Allen replaced him with an injured leg a moment ago. First and 10, 21. 12:40 left first half. Tulsa on top, 7-0. Osborne looking back to pass. Now he's going to keep it. Goes around the left side. And he's going to get maybe a yard or two. Kevin really stacked up the play pretty well in the defensive line for Tulsa. Also, the left cornerback, Brent Dennis, came up to help out, as well as Timmy Gibbs, the strong safety, who thought would not be a passing play, and then came up to help out on the tackle.
Brings up a third down situation for New Mexico. They've made one out of two second and eight.
Second and eight at the Tulsa 19-yard line. Osborne looking back to throw, looking to the right side. He's got his man, a man coming out of the backfield. It's Michael Johnson. He's down across the 15 to the Tulsa 13-yard line. A gain of six, and the Lobos now will have third down and short yardage as they're starting to smell that end zone.
Now we bring up that third down situation. The Lobos, one out of two on third.
Third and two at the Golden Hurricane, 13-yard line. The TU defense has been on the field for a long time. David Osborne brings them out. They're in the Veers put back option offense that they employ. Osborne looking for Michael Johnson. The junior has it. He looks like he should have the first down. It may be close enough for a measurement. He's down. He needed to get to about the 10.5-yard line. He's down between the 11 and the 10, Bob, and I think they're going to take a measurement.
They are. This will be the first time we've seen the chain gang in a ball game. Very impressive drive by the Lobos. They've moved the ball well. The only penalty in the drive has been against New Mexico, and yet they fought it and continue to drive.
The sticks are down. There's the measurement. It is a first down for New Mexico. So the Tulsa defense continues to dig in. The seventh first down in the ball game for the Lobos. 11:18 left. Second quarter of play. First and 10 at the Tulsa 11. Osborne looking for it all into the end zone. McGee just can't reach it. A little bit too tall for 5'10 senior Keith McGee, helping out Brent Dennis. Coming over also with Timmy Gibbs, the strong safety. And it'll be second and 10 as the Lobos went for six right there.
They went for it all on first and 10 from the 11. Osborne going into the hole for McGee, who, as we had said earlier, caught five scoring passes during the season. We also had a flag on the play. No, now we have a flag on the play as they line up. And it's going to be illegal motion, it looks like, against New Mexico. They look like they lined up, Bob, and somebody gave a little bit of a move in the backfield on second and 10. Let's check in with the referee, Vance Carlson, and see what the call was.
Illegal procedure, offense, second down.
That'll move them back 5 yards. It'll be second and 15 at the 16. Another costly penalty for the Lobos, but they've come back very strongly here whenever they've been penalized. David Osborne, the quarterback. He's got Denny Allen to his left. Michael Johnson to his right behind him in the split back there. He gives it off for Allen. Allen off left tackle. Has maybe three or four. Down to about the 12-yard line. It'll be third and long yardage by the Lobos. Third and 11 now at the 12 as the clock continues to run with 11:01 left before halftime.
Allen with three carries for 17 yards since replacing Carter. All right, everybody gets to play quarterback right here. Third down and 11 from the 12. What do you call here?
You got to think pass for the Lobos right now. Third and 11 at the 12. Clock running down now to about 10:33. Mike Johnson has the football on a draw play. He's got good yardage down inside the 5 to the 3-yard line. Oh, what a good call there by the Lobos, Bob. We were thinking pass. David Osborne went back to throw and then just kind of skipped it off for Mike Johnson. He got big yardage. He got a gain of 9.
And listen to that Lobo crowd. They love their ball club as they brought it down to a 4th-and-2 situation at the 3. David Osborne's going to have to ask for quiet.
Well, they thought they were going to go over to the sidelines for a timeout momentarily, but then they decided to go ahead and do it. So it looks like they're going to go for it here on 4th-and-2 from the 3, trying to tie the ball game. David Osborne with the two backs behind you and everybody inside on the offensive line, including the tight end, John Wayne. He's got the football. He ducks in behind left tackle. Touchdown, New Mexico! David Osborne in behind his left tackle. It was 7-8 clearing the way against Kevin Lilly and Joe Blackenship of Tulsa. And the Lobos are on the board with 10-08 left.
Very, very impressive drive. Threw the ball well, they ran the ball well, mixed it up, as you mentioned a couple of plays ago, an obvious passing situation, and they ran it. Big drive for the Lobos to even it up.
On to attempt upon after is the senior from El Dorado, Arkansas, P. Park, 45 of 46 this year in his career, 92 out of 98. The snap is down, it looks good, the kick is up, Tracy Mount on the hold, and it is good. So, with 10 minutes and 8 seconds left before halftime, we have a tie football game. The Lobos of New Mexico 7, the Golden Hurricane of Tulsa 7. We'll be back with more second quarter action in the Justice Bowl 82 after this timeout.
Driving all night in the rain and the weather, can't see 10 feet ahead. My arms are sore, my body's tired, and my feet are feeling like lead. There's only two reasons I push this rig clear across the U.S. of A. One, I need the paycheck, and two, I get to eat my rainbow bread on the way.
I'm an 18-wheeler, reflex-wheeler, fat-taking son of a gun. I can drive from Maine to California, right near to the sun. Put my rig to bed. That's when I grab me some fatty cake, a good fresh rainbow bread. I'm an 18-wheeler, reflex wheeler. When I'm off the road, that good bread, fresh bread, can turn up the load.
Bob Stevens back with Bob Carpenter and Mike Roberts. 79 yards in 15 plays. They had the ball for almost 6 minutes. Great drive by New Mexico. They had three third down situations and a fourth down and made the touchdown.
High atop Amon Carter Stadium here, the press box, as we look to the east. City of Fort Worth spread out in front of us. The campus off to the right. Crowd of 47,000 here at the ballpark this afternoon. They've seen a great one so far. The TU fans in their blue and gold celebrating. The Lobo fans in their red and silver. The TCU fans here are dressed in black. Why not? They went 2-11 this year.
Oh, tough season for the TCU Horned Frogs and their fans. They're glad to see a couple of winning teams here. That's one of the reasons Fort Worth hosting the bowl.
I guess it was only 2-9, but it seemed like 2-11 to the Horned Frog fans. Here we go with the kickoff. Pete Park kicking off for New Mexico. It's down to the Tulsa 4-yard line. Benny May on the kickoff return. May breaks it at the 15, across the 20, out to about the 24-yard line. Benny May, the senior from Fort Worth, Texas, making his first appearance here at home on the kickoff return, averaging 18.7 a return that time. He took it 20 yards, so TU will start first and 10 at its own 24-yard line. 9:58 left before the end of the first half in this tie ball game.
Benny May, an all-purpose player for the Golden Hurricane from Fort Worth Dunbar High School. New Mexico, 120 yards in total offense now. TU is 73.
First and 10 for the Hurricane at its own 24. TU scored on its last offensive drive. Get past the quarterback, the senior from Phoenix. Giving off to the second man through, it's Ken Lacy. Lacy out across the 25 to the 28-yard line. Brought down there by the great linebacker, Johnny Jackson. Helping out on that side as well was Julius Johnson, number 24, the right cornerback, who had a severe sprained ankle earlier this season. He missed three ball games, then came back to register 45 tackles and two interceptions.
Michael Gunter making a good block to spring Lacy free. It's very interesting. These guys block so well for each other.
Second and six for the Hurricane at the Tulsa 28-yard line. Tie game. Skip pass giving off now for Michael Gunter, the junior from Gladewater, Texas. Just a couple of yards out near the 30-yard line. Kelly Wilson, the nose guard, there to stop him. Unable to clear the way, David Ines, TU center. Also helping out on the tackle was Gary Butler, the left linebacker, who really doesn't get a lot of publicity because of the guy he plays alongside, Johnny Jackson. It'll be Second and 6 for Tulsa.
Lacy, 6 carries for 24 yards. Gunter, 5 for 27. Lacy with the touchdown.
Let's check that. It'll be 3rd and 4 for the Hurricane at its own 30-yard line. Skip pass. Option right. Keeping. He's got some running room. He's going to get the first down out near the 35-yard line of Tulsa. It'll be a 1st and 10 for the Hurricane as Skip Ass kept the football, Bob, and got out there for 5 yards.
And a good first down for the Hurricane. Skip keeping the ball. He had the option to run it or to throw to the tight end, Kurt Steinhauer, who was open over the middle.
Clock running, 8:45 left. Second quarter play. Skip Ass, 45 of 102 this year for 596 yards. He also rushed for 367 yards. 4 touchdowns through the air and 4 on the ground. Sweep left for Tulsa. Michael Gunter with a football. He's got some running room. He's across the 40, not out of bounds, at about the 42-yard line. The left cornerback, Sammy Parrish, knocked him out, as well as the linebacker, Jerry Butler, and the strong safety, Huey Chancellor. But a good game for Tulsa as Gunter gets 7, and Tulsa will have a 2nd and 3.
Chancellor and Parrish, 2 excellent seniors, playing their last game for the Lobos. Gary Butler, the linebacker from Mesa, Arizona, will be back for New Mexico.
Gunner, 6 rushes so far, 34 yards. It's 2nd and 3 for the Hurricane at the Tulsa 42-yard line. Gunner again has the handoff from Skip Ass. Not much there. As Johnny Jackson set things up in the middle, Kelly Wilson, the nose guard, also there. Maybe a 1 yard gain for Tulsa. It'll be 3rd and 2 now at Tulsa's 43-yard line.
Johnny Jackson, the sophomore out of Linwood, California. What a player. This guy has just a marvelous future ahead of him.
Richard Mello, his backup, a junior, may not get a chance to play much before his career ends. Jackson, only a sophomore, an incredible player. 3rd and 2 at the 43. Looking for Lacy. He's got the handoff, and he's got the first down. Kenny Lacy up across the 45-yard line to the 46. Knocked down there by Ray Hornsek, the great free safety who came up to make the stop. Hornsek this year, 75 tackles, 4 interceptions. Just a super year. A 99-yard return for a touchdown against Air Force, which was the turning point in that ball game.
And the best news is, for Lobo fans, he's only a sophomore.
1st and 10 for Tulsa at the 46. 6 first downs to the Hurricane, 4 of them on the ground. That's pretty much what we expected. Skip Ass, option right, takes the handoff to Lacy. He's going to keep. He's got a couple of yards out around the 48-yard line. Knocked down there by Al Greenwood, the 6'1 senior from Ontario, California, the left defensive tackle.
Hurricane offensive line feels now they can move New Mexico out. 7 straight rushing plays. Pearson, Kaspersky, Imes, Cox, and Abramowitz for TU. Cox and Abramowitz, the guys on the right side that have done most of the damage.
Tulsa staying on the ground. 2nd and 8 at the 48. Skip Ass is looking back to throw. He's looking for Gunter out of the backfield. It's underthrown, and Gunter just didn't come back enough for the football. Skip Ass did not throw the ball well. He had that problem on a pass earlier in the game where he underthrew it. And it'll be 3rd and 8 now for Tulsa at the 48-yard line on the incompletion.
You know, Bob, you'd imagine that TU would go to Gunter and Lacy out of the backfield with the passes a little more often. The two only caught 14 passes all season long between them. Hurricane facing a 3rd down situation. They are 4 out of 5 in the ballgame.
3rd and 8 at the 48. Skip Ass auctioning to the left. He's going to keep it. He's not going to get the first down. He fumbles. It's recovered by New Mexico. It looks like number 92, the left defensive end, Mark Eastamp from Clovis, New Mexico, the 6'2 junior, has the football. First turnover in the ballgame.
They thought they only played basketball in Clovis. Mark Eastamp making the fumble recovery. Skip Ass had some running room, picked up 4 yards, but then the ball popped loose. Easton falls on it, New Mexico, with great field position.
1st and 10, New Mexico, at their own 48-yard line. Skip Ass got across midfield and then coughed it up, and Mark Easton with a big recovery. Easton on the year, 68 tackles, and he recovered 3 fumbles during the season, so chalk up number 4 for the junior. Number 4 for the junior. First and 10, New Mexico at the 48-yard line. By the way, Raven comes in to replace Johnson at running back. Carl Raven, a 5'8 sophomore from Houston. And good news for Lobo fans, a 5'9 senior Mike Carter returns at running back. David Osborne looking back to throw. Left side, Darwin Williams, he's got it. At the 30, down all about the 31 of Tulsa. Oh, a great throw from David Osborne. And Darwin Williams went high in the air to pull it down.
Darwin Williams doing a great job of splitting the seam. He got in behind the linebackers in front of Gibbs and Beasley in the secondary and hauled it in. First and 10 Lobos.
The Lobos are on the move at the Tulsa 31-yard line. Osborne with a super pass there. We'll see what he does here on first and 10. He's looking on the handoff for Carl Raven, number 26. He's got good running room across the 30. Down to about the Tulsa 25-yard line. A gain of 6 for the sophomore from Houston.
An impressive stable of running back for the New Mexico Lobos. 6.7 yards per carry for Carter on the year. Johnson 6.3. Benny Allen 6 yards a carry. Carl Raven 5.6. They got another guy, Willie Terrell, who averages 8.5 yards a carry.
Lobos good yardage on first down. Second and 4 at the Tulsa 25-yard line. First carry back in the ball game for Mike Carter. He's loose beyond the 20, down to about the 13, maybe the 12-yard line, but flags on the play, and it looked like New Mexico, Bob, lined up offside.
It looks like Keith McGee is going to be the culprit, the flanker back, as he was actually lined up as a split end, and Derwin Williams didn't step back when they changed formation. So they're going to have 8 men across the front. I think they're going to pay for it. Let's get out of the field and Vance Carlson.
That'll move the football all the way back to the 30-yard line. As you heard the officials say, second down and 9 at the 30. They had a second and 4 at the 25. Mike Carter got that ball all the way down to the 12, and the penalty really cost him 18 yards. Second and 9 now. Osborne looking. Left side, Derwin Williams. It'll fall incomplete. Williams did a little curling pattern down to about the 21-yard line. Ball was thrown too low, and he couldn't come back far enough to get it, and the pass fell incomplete.
Bob Babbitt, the linebacker, coming up to make the play. Babbitt for the Golden Hurricanes, setting up Osborne statistically at 5 for 8 for 75 yards. Great first half.
Big play in the ballgame now. Third and 9 for the Lobos at the Hurricane 30-yard line. You got to be thinking pass of the way Osborne's been throwing the football. He'll be looking for Derwin Williams or Kevin, or rather Keith McGee. Williams has been the big man for the Lobos so far. Osborne back to throw. He's got time. Looking for Keith McGee. He's got him. Down to the Tulsa. 17-yard line out of bounds. It'll be a first down for the Lobos.
The sophomore John Cooper, the coach's son from Tulsa Memorial High School, getting picked on that time. He was in to replace Kelly Beasley, 6'1", 177 sophomore. McGee now 3 catches for 38 yards. He is a dandy.
He led the Lobos during the season with 39 receptions for 641 yards, a 16.4 yards average, and 5 touchdowns. A 5'10 senior from San Diego, and he can really move it. First and 10 at the Tulsa 17-yard line. Osborne back to throw again, looking for the tight end, John Lane, incomplete. Pass was tipped away there by Brian Burroughs, the linebacker, who was getting outside to make the defensive play following the tight end, and it'll be an incomplete pass. Second and 10 for the Lobos, still at the Tulsa 17.
Again, the Lobos won their last bowl appearance. That was 21 years ago, the Aviation Bowl. If they beat Western Michigan 28-12, you remember that Aviation Bowl, don't you, Bob?
Sure, didn't we recreate that one?
Oh, boy.
Second and 10 after 17. New Mexico lining up. Uh-oh, a little bit of movement in the backfield. And flags are flying as New Mexico had some, look like, illegal motion in the backfield, and that will cost them 5. Let's get on to the official, Vance Carlson, for the call. Second and 15 at the 22. New Mexico really hurt by penalties so far. 5 for 30 yards. Tulsa whistled down just once for 10. Second and 15 at the Tulsa 22-yard line. By the way, in to replace Mike Carter again is Denny Allen, that running back.
Denny Allen brought a play with him. This might be something a little bit special out of Joe Morrison's bag of tricks.
We'll see whose number he called. Osborne back to throw, looking. It's Allen out of the backfield. He's got it inside the 15, down to the Tulsa 10-yard line. Oh, a big play for the Lobos.
Denny Allen, we talked about the little guy, 5'8", junior out of Gainesville, Florida, as a great running back, averaging 6 yards a carry, but he can also catch the ball, 8 catches for 98 yards on the season.
That was a big play for the Lobos now, because they are 3rd and 3 at the 10, Bob, instead of 2nd and 15, and Osborne, some great numbers so far, 7 out of 11 for 100 yards. It'll be 3rd and 3 at the 10.
He is rolling them well, 7th and 11.
Osborne on the keeper, optioning left. He's down inside the 10 to the 6, maybe the 5-yard line. But nevertheless, he's got the first down to the Lobos. Knocking on the door once more. First and goal at the Tulsa 5.
Kent, first down to the Lobos offensively. They have put on their second consecutive very impressive drive after the turnover.
Clock running with under 5 minutes left in the first half of play. Tie ball game. Tulsa scoring in the first quarter. New Mexico in the second, threatening here again. First and goal at the 5. Mike Carter is back in the ball game for Denny Allen. The handoff from Osborne to Carter up the middle. Touchdown! Carter bowls into the end zone, carrying a couple of Hurricane players with him. Brian Bruner was all over him. Cliff Abbott trying to help out from his linebacker position, but Carter was not to be stopped, and New Mexico has this lead for the first time in the game.
Mike Carter's just a little guy at 5'9", 190, but he carried, as you said, Brian Bruner and Kevin Lilly into the end zone, a couple of guys that are 240-plus pounds. Carter, 6 carries, 27 yards, he gets the score.
2 parts gone to attempt the extra point, the senior from El Dorado, Arkansas. Counting his successful one earlier in this quarter, he's now 46 to 47. Kick is up. It is good. So with 4 minutes and 46 seconds left before halftime, the Lobos cap another drive after a TU turnover, and they lead it by a score of 14 to 7. Justice Bowl 82 continues after this timeout.
Of the 5 largest Tulsa banks with assets of at least $100 million, F&M Bank ranks number 1 in return on average assets, return on stockholders' equity, and capital-to-asset ratio. In business, F&M performs. We're the right size at the right time. The F&M Bank and Trust Company.
Where business is concerned, we're concerned at F&M. We're the right size at the right time.
Member FDIC. The Vault, a private, high-security facility to store your papers and valuables, from jewelry to gold, to silver and collectibles. The Vault offers ultimate protection in sophisticated surroundings. Select from small security boxes on up to uncommonly large boxes. The Vault even offers cased rifle storage and fireproof, high-security computer data storage. A 6,000-pound steel door, a guard, and video surveillance. A personal key system that ensures no one can open your vault box but you. And the vault is the only place offering high-security, short-term storage. Open 7 days a week, the vault brings you the advantage of ready access. And there's even a handsome conference room for your private convenience. Check out the vault today at 71st and Lewis in South Point Center or call 496-1048. You'll be impressed. Secure, convenient, private. The Vault. Meeting the special needs of individuals and business. Call today. They're open, 496-1048.
Bob Stevens and Bob Carpenter, 8 plays, 52 yards, 219. The time of the possession, New Mexico. Big Mo is wearing red and blue, red and silver right now for the Lobos.
14-7, the Lobos lead the Hurricane. Their fans are feeling good right now. Pete Parks is back to kickoff. He's running up to the football. There it is. It's a high one. It'll fall a little short to the Tulsa 8-yard line. Kirk Phillips on the return. He's across the 10 to 15, across the 20 to the 25, and out to about the Tulsa 27-yard line. A good return by Kirk Phillips, who is averaging 17.9 per return, his longest 29, and he got that one 19. So Tulsa will start now first and 10 at its own 27.
We talk about Big Mo wearing red and silver. 126 yards in offense for New Mexico here in the second quarter. Tulsa with just 28 yards. We might expect you to open things up here a little bit. Skip Ash looking back to throw. He's looking long to his left. It's in the air. Now to the New Mexico 42, a 31-yard passing play from Skip Ass to the senior put-in, Kirk Phillips.
Kirk Phillips' second catch in the ball game for 49 yards. He has caught the leading Hurricane receiver, Skip Ass, now 3-for-6 on the afternoon.
The biggest offensive play of the day for Tulsa in terms of yardage, a 31-yard gain, and Skip Ass threw that ball with authority. First and 10 at the Lobo 42-yard line. Ass looking to his right, handoff. Ken Lacy's got some room. He's down inside the 40 to about the 35-yard line. A 7-yard gain for Kenny Lacy, and Tulsa quickly on the move.
Hurricane trying to strike quick. As you mentioned, Bob, he goes with the long pass to open it up and then goes right back to the ground game. We might see TU now settle down and try to ram it home.
Joe Morrison and his defensive coordinator, Joe Lee Dunn, the new head football coach at New Mexico, pacing the sideline. John Cooper on the near line, watching his offense at work. Second and 3 at the 35. Skip Ass takes the handoff, keeps it. He's going to get the first down. He had to get to the 32. He got down to the 31-yard line. Jimmy Carter, the right defensive end, making the tackle. He had 107 of them this year. And the right cornerback, who had 45, Julius Johnson. But it is a first down for the Hurricanes.
That's first down number 8 for the University of Tulsa. You talk about Joe Morrison and Joe Lee Dunn. Morrison said, as long as we're winning, I'm the coach. When we get behind Joe Lee, welcome to Major College Coaching.
First and 10 for the Hurricane at the Lobo 31-yard line. This drive started just a few moments ago, back at the Tulsa 27. The big 31-yard pass play from Skip Bass to Kirk Phillips. Got a bunch of them. Michael Gunter with a handoff. He's down inside the 30, maybe to about the 28-yard line. McCullough 3 yards off tackle, leading the way there, the 6'4 junior from Florida, Missouri, just outside St. Louis. John Kaspersky, the left defensive tackle. Al Greenwood fought him off and made the tackle.
Gunter now 8 carries for 38 yards. He, of course, 1,464 yards in the season. The amazing stat, though, 7.5 yards every time he touched the football.
Second and 7 at the 28-yard line. Skip Ash is back to throw, looking for his tight end on the right, Kirk Steinhauer. The ball is overthrown. It'll be incomplete. Steinhauer, who's caught only 4 passes this year for 42 yards, Bob, in the TU offensive lineman, he's pretty much a blocker. He just doesn't catch the football that much.
Although he's usually the man who's open on that option. He has 2 touchdown catches on the season.
It'll be 3rd and 7 for Tulsa at the New Mexico 28-yard line. Time beginning to become a factor now. Clock stopped with 3 minutes left in the first half. New Mexico on top, 14-7. Skip Ash on 3rd and 7, looking deep. The deep man is the split end, Kirk Phillips. It's incomplete. On the defensive play for the Lobos with the strong safety, Huey Chancellor. The left cornerback, Sammy Parrish, also helping out. And they had Kirk Phillips outnumbered, Bob, and he didn't have much chance to bring that one down.
No, really, Skip Ash did a good job of almost throwing the ball away as he threw it past Phillips. It brings up a 4th down, and now we'll see the great kicker for the Golden Hurricane, the number 10 scorer in the nation this season with exactly 100 points, Sukrum.
Sukrum, 21 of 29, his longest 57 this year. The longest of his career, 58. This will be a 45-yard attempt. The snap is down. Scott Brown on the hold. It's long enough. It's just wide to the right. Oh, Sukrum didn't miss by more than a couple of yards. He had plenty of distance on it. But TU missing on the field goal attempt. The Lobos will get it back with a 7-point lead.
Big miss for Stu Crum right there. As you mentioned, 21 out of 29 on the season. That 21 field goal, fifth in the nation, and only a couple behind the old NCAA record that was shattered by a number of kickers this season.
It'll be first and 10 for the Lobos now at their own 20-yard line. Well, let's check it. It'll be all the way out at the 28 because that's where the snap took place. Raven and Carter are running back for New Mexico. Raven spelling on offense, of course. Michael Johnson, the halfback. First down play. Raven has the handoff. He's up across the 30 to about the 32-yard line. Call it a 6-yard gain. It'll be second and 4 for the Lobos.
One of the problems Stu Crum might have had with that kick as well is he was trying to overcompensate for that 10-mile-an-hour breeze coming out of the south. The Golden Hurricane going into the wind, and 45 yards is a pretty good poke into the wind.
And he even had the distance at that. The ball was just blown wide right by the wind. Second and 4 for the Lobos at the 32-yard line. Osborne is looking back to throw, looking to his right. It's intercepted by T.U. Down to the New Mexico 36-yard line. Bob Babich, the 6-foot-tall senior from Aliquippa, Pennsylvania. He intercepted 4 during the season. He's got another one right here.
Bob Babich making a big play. Returned one of those for a touchdown. That evens up the turnovers at 1 apiece. And the Golden Hurricanes, who are looking at a 14-7 and maybe even 17-7 first half deficit, now have the football with a chance to tie it.
We'll take a timeout. Tulsa first and 10 at the New Mexico 36. When we come back, the Hurricane gets the turnover. We'll see if they can tie it up.
The American Theater Company, Getty, and KJRH-TV are proud to present a musical adaptation of Charles Dickens' famous holiday story, A Christmas Carol. Tickets are now on sale for this family musical, which runs from December 3rd through December 24th at the Tulsa Performing Arts Center. And as a special Christmas gift to you, Getty and KJRH-TV are offering special discount coupons with $1 off any adult ticket. Just stop by your nearest Getty station throughout the Tulsa area and ask for your free Dickens Christmas Carol discount coupon. There's no purchase necessary. The American Theater Company's presentation of Dickens' Christmas Carol, a great way for your family to get into the spirit of the holiday season. Announcing two new reasons to come charging into Getty, Visa and MasterCard. America's most popular credit cards are now accepted at participating Getty stations. It's easier than ever for you to get a tank full of Getty gasoline. Next time you need a fill-up, take your cap off to Getty.
Linebacker Bob Babich, his fifth interception of the year. Tulsa with the football, first and 10 at the New Mexico 36-yard line after the big turnover. Golden Hurricane was throwing the football quite a bit in its last drive. We'll see what they do here. First down play, skip pass, getting off to Lacy. He's up the middle behind the center, David Ein. Maybe got 3 yards, down to about the 34, maybe the 33-yard line. It'll be second and 7. To the Hurricane, moving the football on the ground, clock running, under 2 minutes left. Tulsa, a great chance to tie up the game here just before halftime. Second and 7 at the 33. TU out of the huddle quickly. Skip pass looking for Lacy. Swing pass. He's got him. He's down inside the 30 to about the 25-yard line. It'll be a first down for Tulsa as Skip Bass got Ken Lacy circling out of the backfield.
There's a case where the Hurricane went to the running back out of the backfield and it worked. Earlier in the ballgame, Ass had tried to go to Gunter and was unsuccessful, but this time Ken Lacy's open first and 10 Tulsa.
Coming up at halftime, we'll have a complete wrap-up of the first half. Bob Stevens will talk to Stacy Richardson of the Fort Worth Chamber of Commerce, a TCU grad who's familiar with the area. He'll be telling us all about how Tulsa and New Mexico came to play in this bowl game and some of the great things they've done here throughout the week. First and 10 at the 25. Skip Ass on the option, takes the handoff. He'll keep it. He's down near the 20, brought down there by Chuck Best, the right defensive tackle, maybe to the 21-yard line. Also helping out the great one, Johnny Jackson, the linebacker. It'll be a gain of about four for Skip Ask, leaving Tulsa with a second and six at the 21.
As we talked about it on the pregame show, they're not very big across the front. Chuck Best at the right tackle at only 217.
Quick huddle for TU. Less than a minute left now. Second and six at the 21. Skip Ask looking to throw. He's got Michael Gunter down to about the 15, maybe the 16-yard line. It'll be a third and one for Tulsa.
Big play coming up. As you hear the crowd come to its feet, we're rolling down toward the half-minute mark. TU third down and one at the 16.
The Hurricane stops the clock on the timeout. The ball was not to the sideline, so TU will talk about it here, Bob. And they've got a lot of timeouts left, so this is a good opportunity to use some of them. They'll have a third and one at the 16. I guess there's a variety of things they can do now here during the timeout.
There are a number of things. At third and one, you can go ahead and bowl the ball up, ask and keep on the option and keep them guessing, or you can go ahead and really shake them up and throw the football.
John Cooper, his offensive coordinator, Larry Coker, talking to Skip Ask, the 6-foot-tall senior quarterback from Phoenix. Interesting decision coming up here. Ask now comes back to the huddle and passes the play along to his teammates while the TU band in the background hopes for a score. Third and one at the 16. Big play in the ball game. Skip Ask back to throw. It's incomplete. But a penalty flag on the play. It's thrown in the defensive area. We'll check the call in just a moment.
Very interesting. New Mexico came with a lot of players that time, and maybe Hornfeck, the free safety, may have gotten offside. He was coming on the blitz.
It was the free safety blitz. Let's go down for the call to Vance Carlson, the head referee. Oh, a big play for Tulsa. Offsides against New Mexico gives TU first and 10 at the 11 with 31 seconds left.
Big, big penalty against the Lobos. That's
10 first downs for Tulsa, two of them on penalty.
Right, and a very big one for the Hurricanes.
Tulsa's got to use the time wisely now. First and 10 at the 11. Skip Ask wants to hand it off. Michael Gunter! Michael Gunter was not to be stopped. Once he made his cut outside, Johnny Jackson and Julius Johnson could not catch him, and we may have a tie ball game.
Both teams taking advantage of turnovers. That time, Gunter bowling ahead and breaking free for the touchdown. Under 10 seconds, less than a half. Tulsa just might tie it up.
The clock shows 0-9 left. Drew Crum is on to attempt the extra point. He was 37 of 37 during the season, 1 of 1 today. There's the snap, got round the hold, it's up, and it's good! 9 seconds left in the first half of play, and we're all tied up at 14-14. And Bob Stevens, that has to be a big lift for John Cooper and his Hurricane going into the locker room, possibly tied.
This is a ball club that has been very opportunistic all season. They had just given the ball to New Mexico down 14-7, but then Babbage makes the interception. 5 plays, 36 yards, had the ball for a minute 52, and they get the tying score.
5 plays, 36 yards, a minute 52, as Bob said. And boy, an impressive drive by Tulsa. They moved the football and moved it well, much like the Lobos did on their last drive. And both of the last touchdowns, Bob, by each team set up by a turnover. Now, Stu Crum. We'll see what he does with the kickoff here, as I'm sure they want to avoid against a long run back. He's going to kick the up-in-the-air onside kick. It's high in the air, and Ray Hornfeck falls in the ball at the 33-yard line, and that'll do it for the first half of play. It is halftime at Amon Carter Stadium in Fort Worth. 47,000 fans are on their feet, and we're seeing a tremendous college football game. The first annual Justice Bowl, it's tied 14-14. We'll be back with our halftime activities after this timeout. Thank you. Welcome back to Amon Carter Stadium in Fort Worth. 47,000 fans in the stands. They've seen a tremendous first half. The teams are tied at 14-14. I'm Bob Carpenter along with Bob Stevens, our statistician Elvin Lindblad, our engineers Phil Hall and Rick Allen West. Bob, a super ball game so far.
Boy, and statistically, couldn't be a whole lot more even. New Mexico 10 first downs, Tulsa 10 first downs. Total offense, New Mexico 198 yards, Tulsa with 178. TU, as usual, getting it on the ground, 106 rushing, 71 passing. New Mexico, brilliant balance, 98 yards on the ground, 100 yards through the air. You just can't do a much better job than that. Each team with one turnover, and that's why we're tied at 14.
The TU band is down on the field performing for halftime. We'll be hearing the Hurricane band in the background, and we hope that Mike Roberts can hear us down there with all the noise and everything going on. Let's get on to him for a halftime report. Mike?
The Lobos finally got going in the second quarter. I don't know about Tulsa, but it's a typical New Mexico game. Take advantage of the other team's mistakes, if any. Try to maintain possession of the ball, then throw the bomb. Morrison is always right for long pass. He feels, even if it's not successful, that the secondary will have to respect it. Too bad the folks in Shreveport at the Independence Bowl and the Hall of Fame Bowl in Birmingham couldn't see these two teams in action. A good, solid first half, and we expect more of the same in the second.
Thank you very much, Mike. We look forward to your continued report from the sidelines throughout the game. He makes a good point about the bowl situation, Bob. I think TU and New Mexico very happy to be here in Fort Worth instead of Shreveport or Birmingham.
Oh, they really are. The weather has been fabulous all week. We'll be talking with Stacy Richardson of the Justice Bowl Committee, who's been hosting all of us here this week. It has just been a fabulous week.
We are at halftime. The Golden Hurricane of the University of Tulsa and the Lobos of the University of New Mexico tied a score of 14-14. These are two old schools. They've been around for quite a while. TU opened in 1894, an enrollment of 6,200. The president of the University of Tulsa, J. Pascal Twyman, here with his family for the ball game. And the University of New Mexico, located, of course, in Albuquerque. A student population of 22,405, spread out over 600 acres, opened in 1889 because of the territorial legislature, and the doors opened to students back in 1891. The interim president, John Perovich, the athletic director, John Bridges, they've been very cooperative with us throughout the week, as well as the athletic director and head coach at Tulsa University, John Cooper.
Quickly, some individual statistics in the first half. For Tulsa on the ground, Mike Gunter, 9 carries, 49 yards. Ken Lacy, 9 carries, 37 yards. Skip Ass, 8 carries for 20 yards. Passing, Ass, 5 out of 10 for 71. Kirk Phillips, the leading receiver, 2 catches for 49. The big offensive guy, though, has been Osborne of New Mexico. The quarterback, 7 of 11 for 100 yards. On the ground, 5 carries for 9. The leading rusher for New Mexico, Mike Carter, 6 carries for 27 yards and a touchdown. Johnson, 5 carries for 19 yards. And, of course, Osborne has the other score. Denny Allen, 3 carries for 17 yards.
We've got more halftime activities coming up for you in just a moment. It's 14-14 at halftime as these two 10-1 teams do battle at Amon Carter Stadium in Fort Worth. Stay tuned for more exciting football action on the Justice Bowl Radio Network.
The 1982 Justice Bowl Football Classic is a pre-recorded creation of a game that should have happened but never did.
At F&M Bank, our number one ranking in return on average assets, return on stockholders' equity, and capital-to-assets ratio of the five largest Tulsa banks with assets of at least $100 million is backed by one more trick. Quick response, often within 24 hours. The F&M Bank and Trust Company.
Where business is concerned, we're concerned.